Hello everyone, welcome to my class. Today I am going to discuss about the three cranial nerves of the brainstem. The specific objectives of the today's topic, it includes the functional components of the oculomotor nerve, trochlear nerve, abducens nerve, and course and distribution of the oculomotor nerve, trochlear nerve and abducens nerve, and similarly clinical anatomy of these three cranial nerves. Let us see the cranial nerves of the brain. So the entire brain is consisting of the 12 cranial nerves. The 10 cranial nerves which are arise from the brainstem. The two is oculomotor nerve, trochlear nerve is coming from the midbrain, and similarly the four cranial nerves, the trigeminal nerve, facial nerve, abducens nerve and vestibulocochlear nerve, which is coming from the pons and then pontomedullary junction, and whereas the glossopharyngeal nerve, vagus nerve, hypoglossal nerve, accessory nerve. These four cranial nerves is arise from the medulla oblongata. So today's topic is based on the oculomotor nerve, trochlear nerve and then abducens nerve. So you can see that there is a functional components of the each cranial nerve. Let us see the oculomotor nerve is consisting of the two nucleus. So one is the oculomotor nucleus and Edinger-Westphal nucleus. So here the oculomotor nucleus is consisting of the general somatic efferent that will supply to the all the extraocular muscles except superior oblique and lateral rectus, and whereas the Edinger-Westphal nucleus is concerned, it consisting of the two types of fibers, preganglionic and postganglionic fibers, that will supply to the intraocular muscles of the eyeball. And regarding the trochlear nerve is concerned, it consisting of the one nucleus in the form of general somatic efferent that will be piercing to the superior oblique muscle. And similarly, abducens nerve also, it is consisting of the only one nucleus that will be piercing to the lateral rectus muscle. So you have to note down that all the cranial nerves are in motor in nature. These are motor in nature. So let us know about the oculomotor now. So here you can see that this image will give the exact information about the origin and then the functional components, course, intracranial course of the enter two nucleus. So here the two nucleus are situated in the cerebral aqueduct in the upper part of the midbrain at the level of the superior calculus. These are the oculomotor nucleus and then Edinger-Westphal nucleus. So these two nucleus are processed to the tegmentum, red nucleus, substantia nigra, then finally attached to the medial side of the crest cerebrae of the midbrain, then passes through the in between the two arteries, superior cerebral artery, posterior cerebral artery, and this entire thing is the course is regarded as the intracranial course of the oculomotor nerve. You can see that here the course and distribution of the oculomotor nerve. As I said that earlier, oculomotor nerve is coming from the ventral aspect of the midbrain at the level of the superior calculus, then enter into the tentorian notch of the tentorium cerebelli to reach the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. From there the nerve is enter into the orbit through the superior orbital fissure inside the common tendinous ring. Then after exit from the superior orbital fissure, the nerve is divides into superior division and inferior division. So the superior division, it will be piercing to the superior rectus and the levator palpebrae superioris. Whereas the inferior division is concerned, it will be piercing to the medial rectus, and inferior oblique muscle. The inferior oblique muscle fibers that will be extended through the ciliary ganglia, then it will be contribute to form the short ciliary nerves, where it will be piercing to the sphincter papillae and then ciliary muscle. You can see that here the branches of the oculomotor nerve. So it is consisting of the five muscles. It will be piercing to the near about five muscles: levator palpebrae superioris, superior rectus, medial rectus, inferior oblique, and inferior rectus, except lateral rectus and superior oblique. You can see this image, trochlear nerve, which is regarded as the fourth cranial nerve. So this trochlear nerve is arises from the dorsal aspect of the midbrain at the level of the inferior calculus. Then this nerve is passes upwards crisscross manner, then it will be passes through the superior orbital fissure, then it will be piercing to the superior oblique muscle. So it consisting of the trochlear nucleus, that is then general somatic efferent. The course and distribution of the trochlear nerve, let us see the course and relation and distribution. The trochlear nerve, which is arises from the dorsal aspect of the midbrain at the level of the inferior calculus, then this nerve is piercing to the dura mater and enter the under surface of the tentorium cerebelli, from where it will be reached to the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus, and from the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus the nerve is enter into the orbit through the superior orbital fissure. Then after exit from the orbit, this nerve is piercing to the superior oblique muscle, and this flow chart will give the exact information about the course and distribution of the trochlear nerve. Let us know about the abducens now. It is a purely motor in nature. It consisting of the only one nucleus, that is the general somatic efferent or abducens nucleus. It is arises from the fourth floor of the fourth ventricle at the level of the ventrolateral aspect of the lower pons, means pontomedullary junction, beneath the facial canaliculus. Then it will be, this is the superior orbital fissure. Then it will be piercing to the lateral rectus muscle. Let us know about the course and distribution of the abducens now. So once again, the abducens now, which is arise from the pontomedullary junction, then it will be passes through the pontine cisterna. It will be enter into the fibrous sheath in the form of Durlow's canal, then enter into the inferior petrosal sinus to reach the cavernous sinus. From the cavernous sinus, the nerve enter into the orbit through the superior orbital fissure inside the common tendinous ring, from where the nerve is piercing to the other side of the lateral rectus muscle. So this flow chart will give the exact information about the course and distribution of the abducens nerve. So once again, we have to recapitulate about the all the three cranial nerves. Let us see oculomotor now. So it consisting of the two nucleus, oculomotor nucleus and Edinger-Westphal nucleus. This will be supplied to the intraocular muscle, and whereas the oculomotor nucleus is concerned, it divides into two divisions, superior division and then inferior division, that will be piercing to the superior oblique and levator palpebrae superioris, the inferior division that will be piercing to the inferior rectus, medial rectus. So these are the common information about the oculomotor nerve. Whereas the trochlear nerve is concerned, is the fourth cranial nerve, which is arise from the dorsal aspect of the midbrain at the level of the inferior calculus. This nerve is piercing to the only superior oblique muscle in either side of the extraocular muscle, eyeball. And regarding the abducens nerve is concerned, it is arise from the pontomedullary junction, passes through the pontine cisterna, through the one small canal, that is the Durello canal. From there, after that, it will be reached to the cavernous sinus. From there, it will be enter into the orbit through the superior orbital fissure. Then it will be inside the common tendinous ring. From there, it will be piercing to the either side of the lateral rectus muscle of the eyeball. And this chart will give the information about the action of the extraocular muscles. You can see that there is a here superior oblique muscle, inferior oblique muscle, superior rectus, inferior rectus, medial rectus, lateral rectus. And these are the common action of the nerves of the oculomotor nerve, trochlear nerve and abducens nerve. Particularly the levator palpebrae superioris, that will be assisting the elevating and retracting the upper eyelid, and also this muscle will help to produce the facial expression. A smaller contribution is there, that is located in the eyeball particularly. So clinical anatomy of the lesion of the oculomotor nerve, trochlear nerve, abducens nerve. Let us see. You can see that oculomotor nerve lesion. So the left side of the eye is normal, and whereas the left side of the right side of the eye is going to be squint, lateral squint, means the eye is looking in a different direction. So this is happened in the condition of the diplopia of the lesion of the oculomotor nerve. The eyelid deviate laterally by the action of the unopposed lateral rectus muscle. And whereas the second image, it shows the left side of the eye is normal, and whereas the right side of the eye, the upper eyelid is going to be drooping. So partially it will be closed, the eye is partially closed due to the paralysis of the levator palpebrae superioris muscle. Then let us know about the here the third image, bulging of the eyeball or protruding the eyeball, commonly seen in the paralysis of the all the extrinsic muscles of the eye except superior oblique and then lateral rectus muscle. So let us know about the lesion of the trochlear now. You can see that here also the boy will have the left side of the eye is normal, whereas the right side is going to be deviate. So here, due to the paralysis of the superior oblique muscle, because of the trochlear nerve is responsible to piercing the superior oblique muscle, causing to the diplopia while looking downwards. You can see that here, and also you can see that there is a abducens nerve lesion. The left side of the eye is normal, and whereas the right side of the eye is going to be injured due to the impaired action of the lateral rectus muscle. The lateral rectus muscle is going to be paralyzed, so the affected eye will tend to deviate inward. The eyeball cannot move laterally beyond the midpoint, leads to the medial squint. So here the abnormal deviation of the eyeball is known as a squint. Squint means it's a the eye look in a different direction. So the one eye is a it will be calm normal, the other side of the eye or both eyes sometimes, if it is the damage of the in either side of the same muscles, so that both eyes should be affected. You can see that competency based curriculum of MCI. You can read out the question carefully. These are the questions are related to the annual examination, oculomotor nerve, which is claimed for the essay question, and the rest of the trochlear nerve, abducens nerve is a short essay, and functional components of the all the three cranial nerves are also very important, and lesion of the oculomotor nerve, trochlear nerve and abducens nerve, this is also very important. So if you really benefit through this topic, or you can realize to appreciate the topic, so subscribe my channel. Thank you very much for watching my video. Thank you.